tongue and his gums and his teeth, just like you did. And no horse wants a metal bar in his mouth, and no horse wants you full on. But most horses, they don't mind turning whatever you want, and they don't mind stopping when you want either. If you think they want to keep dropping circles around here with you on their back, you are sadly mistaken. They're lazy. They want to stop. So if they want to turn and they want to stop, why should we have to pull the reins all the time? Well, it's because if that is the very first aid we use in a cue, in other words, if the very first indication that your horse gets that you want him to stop or turn is a pull on his mouth, why would he listen to anything else? Nothing else matters. If, in other words, if there is no way for him to avoid the pull on his mouth, why should he bother listening to what you're doing with the rest of your body? But if he can come to learn that if you listen to what I'm doing with my legs and my seat and even my arms, so I might move my arms, but I don't have to pull on the reins, so straight. So if we can give our horse an option, if we can use our aids in such a way that the pull on the rein comes last, or maybe not at all, so if my horse stops when I want it to, well, that's all right. And if my horse learns that he listens to my voice and my face, I won't pull him. I will stop
good.
Check your position, make sure you're sitting nice and tall, nice and vertical, weighting your heels.